In this video, I cover a comprehensive guide to hand signals that all divers should know and can use. All signals are made using one hand only. The first is a command signal, and that's okay. With any command signal, you must repeat it back, and in fact, all signals should be repeated back to confirm you understand them, and you either agree and feel the same, or you disagree and then you have a problem. If you have a problem, it's important you communicate what that problem is, and that's a flat hand wiggling side to side. It could be that your problem is cramp, and then you show where you have the cramp, most likely in the legs. It could be that your problem is with your light, or a very common problem, with your ears or equalizing. And there is no point replying okay to somebody if they give you an okay if you have a problem like with your ears. Another command signal is stop. This is when you want somebody to stop moving. A better hand signal, I think, is hold. This means hold position. You reconfirm with the same signal, then you hold until the person who made it breaks the signal. They may say line, hold, or hold a line. We have descend, and you should only descend when you get the same signal back. One of the most important command signals is dive over, let's go up. This could be you and me, let's end the dive. You and me, we face each other during the ascent. You can use the same thumb up signal, this time with a finger out, and this points the direction of your exit. Let's ascend, and we both face into the direction of the current. If you're using a dive light, the light points into the hand that you make the signal with. This signal is turn the dive, and you should use this instead of using the thumbs up. Use the turn a dive, and you do this at the halfway point. The same using a light. Next we have direction left or direction right. It's very important that the thumb stays down and you do not show the thumb up, as that would confuse it with the dive over signal. This is a great one-handed signal for what's your air pressure. I hope the one-handed signal replaces the current two-handed signal, as it's very common for dive guides and instructors to have one hand occupied. Number one, number two, number three, number four, and number five. All open palm with the hand vertical. Now hand turns to side, knuckles face diver, six, seven, number eight, three fingers facing the diver, number nine. We don't have 10, so we use zero. And to actually give the number 10, we use one with a pause, then zero. It's important hand signals are done slowly. This is just way too fast, so you slow down. 1, 5, 0. This is the signal for big. It could be used for there's a big or strong current. The signal for small is the opposite. Start large, move the fingers closer. This could be useful if you're showing someone they have small bubbles leaking from their high pressure hose, for example. The scissors mean cut. This is good for cut the exercise. Next is a very useful signal, and that's broken. If a piece of equipment is not working properly or it's broken, for example, your dive computer, you just point at it and then give the broken signal. could also be another piece of equipment that's broken. For example, a compass. This is a signal for compass. Another option is, what is our compass direction? This signal is level off. This means to maintain the level or depth you're currently at. This is question, which is great for letting someone know you're unsure or you need extra information. Like, for example, what is our compass direction? This is add air, and usually you add the air and point to your BCD, or add the air and point to your dry suit inflator. This can be breathe out or blow bubbles, which is easier to show underwater as you actually blow bubbles at the same time. This is getting somebody to think about what they're doing or remember something like, this is our ascent point. Another option for breathe out, and this can also have breathe in with the hand coming back towards the face. I prefer to use this breathe in and breathe out option rather than blow bubbles. This is breathe in a small amount. Breathe in and out a small amount. One of my favorites is the finger signaling yes. Useful if you have your mouth full and want to agree with somebody. And the opposite is no. This is good as it's very clear and says no, like if you don't want to dive deeper. This is come here or come closer. Switch places, or you and me switch sides. It's useful if you're the person in front, but you now want your teammate to go in front. You use this switch positions signal. This is you and you move apart, which is great if you're swimming and you want somebody to understand you need them to move apart. If somebody's too far away, you and you get together. And we've all seen somebody doing the two-handed signal to us at some point while we were learning. But we need a one-handed signal for everything. This is the get together signal. This is asking somebody to think or assess themselves for narcosis. So, are you feeling narcosis? Is a flick on the cheek. And if you do feel it, then you come up is the correct signal. So this is asking someone to come up or move shallower. This is the I'm out of air signal. A slash across the throat. This is hand off your long hose and deploy the long hose. This is you go out of air. Used when practicing the exercise. This is drop, which is useful in skills like drop a stage cylinder. This is the signal for line, or it could also be rope. It's useful to combine lots of different signals like hold the line, for example. This is the signal for don't look down. Good when you're doing advanced buoyancy work and you want people not to look down, and instead you want them to keep their head up and look forwards. This I use for double-ended bolt snap, which is great if you need to borrow a double-ended bolt snap from a buddy. This is write down in your wet notes or slate. Could also be take out your wet notes and make notes, like for sac rate calculations. This is asking someone to kick their legs. Useful if you're swimming against a current and somebody needs to move a little quicker. If somebody's moving too fast, you slow down. It's very important the person going too fast gives you the same signal back to confirm they understand to slow down. Slow down with the light. And if someone's moving too slowly, you speed up or move faster. This is the signal for current. Make sure you discuss with your teammate what you'll do if you experience current during the dive. This is I'm Cold, the two-handed version we all know. Like I explained, everybody should have a good one-handed version of all the skills. This is take a picture or let's shoot some video. This is a missing dive computer, or you have your main dive computer but you forgot your backup computer, or generally anything that's missing. This is line and I'm entangled. You do that by making a figure of eight. This is the signal for deploy your SMB, which is a skill every diver needs to practice more. This is deploy your second SMB or your backup SMB. This is to take out or operate your reel or spool. This is to level off at a depth of 5 meters. This is to level off at 5 meters, and everybody should hold there for 3 minutes, like you do when making a safety stop. This is asking somebody to think about which way the current is going. Then, is that to the left or to the right? Is the strength small or large? You can see it's useful to have a series of hand signals, as you can communicate quite a lot underwater. Like for example, you and me, there is now current. We hadn't planned to dive in, so let's abort the dive early. The three and breathe in signals hold 80% lung volume. Two is holding 50% lung volume. And one is holding 20% lung volume. Those signals are used for weight checking. It's important that all team members give clear communications and relay them back, like this diver giving the air pressure and the teammate responding with what he saw.